Well, good morning, good afternoon, good evening to the KOR universe. Today we have, right now we are with Sir Ed Abalos of the Binondo chapter, who happens to be also the campaign manager of Sir Abellana. Sir, would you like to say your salutations to the KOR universe?
Good evening and good morning to everyone, because I don't know the time zone out there. And to all our Sir Knights, Sir Cubs, thank you for, you know, guesting and watching this episode. Well, I'm very privileged to be honored to be in this blog of our brother, Sir Alwin.
Well, thank you for your time, sir. I know it's quite busy now. I know your background is in broadcasting, and I'm pretty sure you're pretty busy, especially now that the election season is coming up. Talking about the election, sir, how did you find the KOR elections? What would be your assessment, sir?
Well, the elections of KOR, well, of course, since it's pandemic and everyone has to take their safety pre-measures, and of course, it's a good thing that KOR already decided to have our elections to be in online form. And everyone out there has the chance to vote, especially our Sir Knights outside the country or abroad. Yes, as a matter of fact, I think the IHQ sent 3 emails. That's a demo email that you can check. I mean, you can try to cast your vote so that just in case the real election time that we are already needed to vote we already needed to cast our votes, we already did two practices prior to the election, the real election date that we had.
Yeah. Of course. What was your role with regards to the, I guess we can call it Abellana candidacy?
Okay, with the Abellana candidacy, well, a lot of us here in Manila knows well Rodel Abellana, Sir Rodel Abellana. No? Number one, he's a very approachable person. Number two, you know, in spite of everything that is happening, well, let's put it this way. We all know it's pandemic. There are hardships in other members or hardships in other people. But, you know, Rodel come across with this situation and, you know, he tries to cheer everyone up.
Now, sir, how long have you known Sir Rodel?
I've known Sir Rodel for almost 5 years because Rodel happens to be also my Freemason brother.
Now, sir, the reason why I asked you how long have you known Sir Abellana or Sir Rodel is because it seems like he really equipped himself with all the necessary elements to win this election. Aside from his natural talents and his natural character, he also put up 11 chapters, if I'm not mistaken, in 2 years. And and that probably explains how he was able to get in being relatively unknown.
Well, that is true. Yeah, he put up 11 chapters and we were surprised and amazed how did he did that, no? Kumbaga sabi ko nga kay Sir Knight Dr. Love, or we call him Dr. Love, no? Sabi ko, how could you put up 11 chapters? Ganong kaka-dedicated talaga sa KOR. Kasi, honestly, when I always, let's put it this way, every Wednesday or Thursday, he will text me, I'm going to Manila. That's straight every week. Then he comes back around Sunday. Then what are you going to do? I'm putting up another chapter like this. Then I need to go back and forth to Manila. Then I have to talk to Miss Maureen. So that's how dedicated he is with the Knights of Rizal.
Now, I've interviewed Sir Rodel, and he comes off as a very positive, very energetic, very charismatic individual. On the other side of the coin, he comes off being on the sinister side of the coin. It comes off as fake, very polished, and very trained, and very calculating. What would you say to the doubters of Sir Abellana?
Well, to the doubters of Sir Rodel Abellana, number one is try to be friends with him. Number two is try hanging out with him. Because why? You know, hanging out with him, you would know what are his perceptions. Second is, what are his plans? Third is, what is his true personality? And I can assure you that Rodel Abellana is a very genuine person.
Very nice. In the 2 years that they will be taking over in the IHQ, has he mentioned what his priorities are to you?
Well, he has mentioned to me some of his plans. As we talked before, he said, you know, people doesn't know RA646. But of course, us, as KOR members, we all know RA646. And that is one thing that he wanted to make sure that everyone gets a full information about RA646, the beauty of being a KOR member. And the information dissemination and knowledge information, that would be one of his advocacy on promoting KOR.
Now, sir, with the quick success of Sir Abellana. He's been only a member since 2019.
Yes.
And that's only 3 years.
Yes, sir.
Yes, he has had a lot of, as you describe, a lot of commitment and managed to put up in those 3 years, 11 chapters, which is amazing. Do you think he has the longevity? Do you think he's a flash in the pan? Having to assume such a big role in the Knights of Rizal, and he beat very well-known people, including Sir Relon, who is incumbent, by the way. But the question is, with this youth and newness, I guess, in the Knights of Rizal, do you think he's a flash in the pan, and do you think he has the longevity to be able to prove himself?
Definitely, yes. He has the longevity to prove himself to everyone. And not just the longevity, but he has the type of attitude to lead everyone to a better perspective of being a Knights of Rizal. You know, it's just not just the position that he is in right now as the Supreme Council. In the Supreme Council, I'm sorry. Because right now, if you're going to ask me, Sir Rodel, actually, since he was elected as the Deputy Supreme Deputy Exchequer. Okay.
Exchequer.
Okay, Exchequer. You know, I talked to him personally. I told him, I asked him, Brother Rodel, Sir Cubs, that's not a joke. That position is not a joke. It's not just an ordinary chapter officer, right? Sabi ko sa kanya, everyone is going to look on you. Everyone is going to follow you. Now, magkamali ka dyan or meron kang hindi magandang ano dyan, it will also affect you. And you know what he answered me? Bro, I only want to serve all the members of KOR. But however, I should follow all the rules and regulations. And also, I should follow our Supreme Commander.
Now, sir, Sir Rodel is a three-time fraternity brother of yours, right? In the Masonry and then the Eagles and then the Knights.
Actually, three.
Yes, three. Now, do you see any... How would you characterize being a member of two other organizations who's also a fraternity, who also has... I'm not familiar, obviously, with the Eagles and the Mason. I'm not. But who have similarities. So how would you characterize that? Is that a disadvantage or an advantage for Sir Abellana?
Well, it's an advantage. Actually, if I will answer you, no? It's an advantage for him and for me. Why? Because not everyone can join Knights of Rizal. Not everyone can join Free and Accepted Masons. But with the Fraternal Order of Eagles, well, there are rules, there are regulations, but of course, I think the Knights of Rizal and Freemason has amity. And it has recognition. Since we have to remember that Dr. Jose Rizal is a Freemason. And his teachings and idealism is it is recognized by the Free and Accepted Masons.
There's been a controversy about black voting, sir, in the this election, that the Freemason really played a very active role in this election. Did Sir Abellana take advantage of that?
That I don't think so. Because everyone has their right to vote. There's the right to choose whoever candidate they want. And as much as I know, everyone has their own free will. Well, of course, I'm candidating, promoting Abellana, but I don't promote other person because they are Freemason brother or fraternal fraternal order of Eagles brother. No, I'm candidating. I'm trying to help his candidacy and by promoting him because I know him as a person.
So, in your experience as a poll watcher, sir, how can you give us a, you know, now that it's still kind of fresh, it's only been a week away, we've only been 7 days away. How did that 19th, the September 19th, how did that your day go that day? Where were you? Who were you with? Kind of walk us through that day.
Yes,
and how you celebrated at the end of the day when you knew that Sir Abellana made the magic 8+1.
Well, it's like this, no? From morning, 9 o'clock, I was there already. I got my swab test. Then after that, I went upstairs, had the breakfast. Then from there, they were already opening the computers and there are people who is trying to vote on site and the other one, they are already from voting from their homes or from their offices because since it's an online voting, you know, the least the thing that you could do is be there, try to hear all these questions from other members like, Sir Knight, paano ba papasok dito? Sir, paano ba boboto dito? Paano? Kasi, you know, it's their first time. Maraming technicalities eh. Hindi naman ganun kadali para, no? So, syempre, as much as possible because I am the deputy commander of KOR Binondo. Now, you know, ako kasi, I try to make sure na kung may mga questions yung mga members natin na hindi nila alam na nagpapa-assist sila, I am there to text them na, okay, ganito gawin mo, call mo ako, ganito ganyan, baka pasok ka, ganito.
Now, how did the day progress? As you come close to 2:30, how can you describe the atmosphere? Obviously, I think you were with Sir Abellana, right?
Yes.
Okay, how was he excited? Was he following the trend or are you able to follow the trend? I'm not familiar.
Yes, everyone is excited. Everyone is like, oh, ito na. Tawag dito, when they're already canvassing the votes, when they're already tallying the votes, siyempre kikita mo kung ilan na yung pumasok, di ba? So, when they were saying, okay, Abellana, they were talking about, oh, Abellana, the numbers were rising and, you know, the feeling is something that there's the joy and excitement, but however, in any you know a matter of minutes that can change. So that time we were just very calm and trying to say if it's for us kung para sa iyo mananalo ka.
So describe the celebration, sir, while in the IHQ when it was clear that he made it.
Yes. When we already knew it was around 2:33 to 2:35, no? It was not exactly 2:30. 2:35, 2:30 something. Past 2:30, we already know that he was already on the winning edge. But however, like what I told him, I told Sir Rodel, bro, it's almost there. They're about to announce it. Much better. Try to clear your mind. And of course, there's going to be a lot of questions. How did you win? How did you get there? There are people who's going to doubt you, but definitely you have to prove them that you are the right choice. They had dinner in Aristocrat.
Right after. Who was there, sir?
I'm sorry?
Who was there?
There was a Sir Jerry Calderon and Sir Ray Sir Ray, I think Sir Ray is with Ray Tan is with the, Sir Jerry Calderon. Sir Greg Lalo was also present there. And Sir Casasola is also Casola is also there, present there. Whom I can recall.
You were there.
Yes, I was there.
You joined them. Okay.
All yes, right. I joined.
Now, sir, you said you were a member of you were a deputy commander. How did your chapter receive the news that you have to pay for this election to be able to vote?
Just only 1,000 pesos. What is 1,000 pesos if that is your privilege to vote? And you have to consider, of course, you have to pay for the technicalities, the IT, the software that they use for voting. It's not a joke. So it's okay. I don't mind. What is 1,000?
So your chapter didn't seem to make an issue out of paying for to be able to vote.
There's no issue. 1,000, it's just only 1,000. It's just money, but the freedom and the liberty of voting, that's priceless.
So, sir, at this point, I really would like to thank you, sir, for giving us the opportunity to pick your brains, especially about this super boy, this wonder boy, Sir Abellana, who is really a surprise to many. But as you said, knowing him for 5 years, you can see his commitment, and it showed the voters saw it, and he was number 5 tied with Casola, I think.
And Sir Alwin Galela, thank you very much for having this interview. I know it's a privilege for me to be part of your interview, and to all our brothers from KOR, maraming salamat po sa pagboto po in behalf of Sir Rodel Abellana, and I would make sure, and we will make sure na lahat po kayo, kung may concerns po, we are very open here to listen to you kung ano pong suggestion nyo, and maybe in the future, maybe we can help you po. Matulungan namin kayo kung ano pong concerns nyo. Maraming salamat po.
Now, sir, before you go, I have one last question. Now, it seems like Sir Rodel is sick. He wants to please everybody. He's a people pleaser. Do you think that would be an issue in when things get heated and things are decisions have to be made that are not popular? Do you think he has it in him to not please everybody? Because I know that's basically how he comes off as very people-oriented, people person. He likes to be liked, and he sings, he dances. You know, he doesn't take himself seriously. But do you think when it comes down to hard decisions, unpopular decisions, do you think he'll be able to cross that?
You know, Sir Rodel Abellana, mukha lang pabling yan. Kakanta-kanta, sasayaw-sayaw, pag titiktok-tiktok, something like that. It's one of his pastime. But when you get to see him on work, he's very different person. Seryosong tao yan. You know, that kind of person, he would say no to you. Why? Because as much as possible, he would want to accomplish or please you in the best way he would be possible. And as for other members or brothers, Sir Cubs, you know, Sir Rodel is a very serious person. He's just portraying a jolly one, but if you get to know him, he's a true person.
Again, congratulations to your team, you know, with Sir Abellana, and obviously, just like any regular Knights of Rizal, we wish the Supreme Council to be successful for the sake of the order. And so thank you, sir, and nanom nismoriat.
Thank you, sir.